Ladies and gentlemen, to the Mo Yu-Gi-Oh! Show, I am your host, Yu-Gi-Oh! And today, we have a deck profile for Pen Magicians. So, we'll go ahead and introduce yourself to the file.
Hey, I'm Jacob Davidson.
Alright, so what do you play? What do you play in your build?
Three Skunk Robot.
Okay, so
obviously, because searches everything in your deck other than Acid Wrath.
Naturally, you can put that right in the center. I got it right in the center. Okay. So now, alright, so we got the main man, the one that searches everything. It's back at three, so you gotta run it, standard.
Basically.
What do we got next?
Three was on it, came back up at 3-2. Stupid idea, stupid card on Konami, whatever.
Yeah, Wisdomai is honestly this was the first card to get hit in the archetype. This card is insanely good. Basically, you place it on your pendulum scale, as long as you have something else, you can pop it. You get to reset the scale. It's so good. Plus, it gives you more in your extra deck. This card is just so good, and since Konami bumped it back up to three, they are basically saying that, like, you know what, balls to the walls, let's go. All right, so we got three of those. What's next?
Three Black Fang.
We got three Black Fang. Okay.
So it's basically like a free monster reborn, and you can have bonus attacks with monster attack.
Right. So basically,
while
it's in your pendulum scale, what it lets you do is lets you target one of your opponent's monsters, cuts their attack half, pops himself, and because of the fact that he was popped, he doesn't care how he was popped. His monster effect allows you to monster reborn a dark spellcaster from your graveyard onto your field. So it's like definitely a good card. Mm-hmm.
We have three double irons. So basically, this card can search any of your graph cards.
Yeah, so basically, this card is like kind of MVP. You can't activate it on your first turn because you don't have a battle phase, but basically, what it does, you do, it lets you target one of your spellcasters during the battle phase. It doubles the battle damage that it does, and it pops itself. And of course, because it pops itself, it gets its other effect, which basically allows you to search your pendulum graph cards, which is basically your spell or your trap card. Definitely a good card. Next.
Probably like the second best card of the deck, Carbonizing. So when it's pendulum summoned from your hand, you can special one from deck. Card's insane. It's a tuner, so you can make Omegas or like the board wipe guy, the Supreme Green Dragon.
Scale 8, level 4. Definitely a power play card right here. It's a tuner. Harmony Magician, basically when it's pendulum summoned from the hand, lets you special summon a magician monster from your deck. So it's definitely a solid card. One card synchro right there. It's definitely a good card to have.
Up next, three girl poison. You play three because like it's a one scale, and if a dark spot monster swings, you can make it gain 1200. Card gets killed, and you can pop face up card your opponent controls or on the field. I think
this is definitely one of the scariest cards in the deck, because like you see this card on your field, you know that anything you run into is gonna run, like it's just gonna run over you. And on top of that, it's gonna get to pop one of your cards. So basically, this card just does too much for the deck. It lets you beat over your opponent's monsters. Lets you wall against your opponent's monsters. And on top of that, it gets you a free pop. You can't be mad at that. Level 4, scale 1, Lego.
White Wing. This card's garbage. Just play against the trainer.
Yeah, for real. Like that card, like. He said it out. You heard it first. The card is straight garbage. Like you only play one of this, whether you're playing Zark or not. It's a tuner. Yeah. It banishes itself when you synchro with it. It's not good, but yeah.
Basically, for like a double Omega play, if you feel like you need it.
Yeah. Plus, it's a scale one, so it's like that's pretty much the only thing it's got going for him. Okay.
One of the best hand traps I personally find.
Yeah, because like basically. Anything, if any one of your monsters get pops, you get to special summon it, and then you get a search.
Like
you get
to
search
monster. For the same thing. So like if you're playing Danko gets killed, you special summon this, search another Danko.
Yeah, it's so good. So good.
Two Oak Dragon, because you need to recycle. If you're going to get like Paleo, even like Spirals, you need it.
Especially since you're playing in Link format, you can only pendulum one monster at a time from the extra deck. You like getting cards back in your hand, like it's just too good.
Yeah.
It's even better than it ever was.
Two Sword. You only play this card because, like, you can search it off your Skull Crobat. And,
right.
It can search off Crobat, and you can kill your Double Iris. So you can, like, pendulum it, pop Double Iris, search your Speller Trap and your Skull Crobat. So it's like a plus two.
Right. Because, like I said, they don't give a shit how they're popped. Yeah. They just want to get popped.
Two, with Valley Apex. Card's kind of trash right now. I just don't have Jewels at the moment, so I'm just using these.
It's not too terrible, though. It's actually pretty good, though, because it goes back into your hand instead of going to the grave. So it's a free negate, goes back in your hand, so you can continuously pendulum over and over and over again. Obviously, Drolls would be better, but you know, Apex, you can't be mad at Apex. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Spicy tech.
Yeah. And one Max C, the God card.
So. Of course, you gotta have Max C.
And that's basically it for monsters.
Alright. Now we're going to back row.
To-Do List Alliance. Basically, it's search any Pendulum card in your deck.
DA is just too good. Like, yeah. you gotta run DA.
So, that's basically whatever. Two Desires, Ash Beat. Whatever.
That is hardcore. Yeah, that feels so bad.
Trapalum Graph. Just searches like any magician you want if a magician leaves the field. Pendulum Magician?
Yeah.
So it's really good. It's continuous. You just keep doing it.
Yeah, so basically, like, this card doesn't give a shit how your Pendulum Moss leaves the field. You can synchro and it'll still get its effect off, so it's really good.
Two Cosmic Cyclone? I just feel like this card's really good.
And yeah, the card is good.
And spoil me a bunch of games just because it's so solid.
Right, right.
One Wavering Eyes, just because, like.
It's back.
It's back, but it's a bad card still. I don't find it too good because if you play.
Late Night Tours with the Wheel.
If you play like three.
If this was pre-links though,
yeah,
definitely play three. Now that it's back at three, definitely. But I think that's the reason why it came back at all, just because of the fact that it's, you know, it's link format.
Garbage, another Ash Bait.
Yeah, that card's not a card you like back when it first came out. When the deck first came out, you wanted to play that. So when you first got this deck, like, you wanted three of these cards, you wanted to get this out. But now it's just like you can't pop your shit, so it's like you don't want that.
Then for traps, two time telegraph, and that's basically it.
This card is the shit. So basically, what happens is you target one card your opponent controls, one Pendulum Magician you control. You send them both to the grave. You pop them both, and if you're unable to pop both cards, then you get to just send something to the grave for free. This card is stupid.
Yeah.
It's so good. All right, so let's check out the extra deck right away.
Two times time magician. This card. Let's just search any monster in your deck other than Sork.
Yeah, right.
And it protects your scales.
It also lets you like proxy for your effects, like send cards from your destroy cards from your deck to grave instead of like using destroying other cards.
Yeah. Like, so it combos off really well with the Trap Pendulum Graph. You target one of your cards, one of their cards, protect your card.
Yeah, exactly.
Card gets killed, they set a card in the field, so it's just.
So you basically get two for the price of one.
Yeah. One Babuska. This card's Baby VFD, or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Good shit.
Yeah, for sure.
Trapeze Magician. This card's just really solid.
He's great for those OTKs. Plus, he pops your Pen Mages, so it's like.
He protects you from taking any damage other than other 25, so that's solid.
That's like that's amazing against a Trickstar game for sure because they don't do more than 200 at a time.
Tornado, just one of the best staple range 4s there are.
Honestly, for real.
Supreme King, Dragon, Dark Rebellion. This card is fucking.
He's cute.
It's insane. It's cute.
He's really cute, but he's strong. He's strong. You can't deny that.
Oh hell yeah! Like,
I play that shit in my Phantom Knights. I go from three to him, and I just, you know, it's good.
You basically
good
summon this, and you just win.
Yeah.
Invisible, just because, like, some people still play like snow turbo.
Yeah.
After that,
ain't got no time for snow.
Raigeki.
yes. Raigeki dot monster.
Yeah. Basically, while you play it.
Yeah.
It's so free.
It is free.
The best synchro ever made, I think.
Hands down.
Yeah.
Pop your opponent's pendulum, shuffle up their opponent's shit in the deck. You can't be mad at that. Boss Monster BLs.
This shit's just so broken.
So good.
You can still get Castell, so recipe.
You get Castell, Kaiju, but still, I mean, like, if your opponent doesn't have that out, like, he's gonna have to deal with it, yeah.
Two Omega, just cause, like,
Omega too strong.
And, card's so broken.
Yeah, he's so good. This is a timeless. Like, when I was testing Lynx back when it was first announced,
yeah.
Like, I was playing Crystron's triple Omega that shit all day, every day. Like, I realized, because, like, it specifically said that monsters only go from the extra deck to the extra monster zone. Yeah. So I knew that if that was the case, it would come back to the main monster zone. Because it's so good. It's so good.
Venom Dragon thing. This thing is just really good, like, if you get Quaking.
This is like copycat. This is copycat
basically,
right here.
It's not really that good. I mean, I've had some uses where you, like, I needed to.
Yeah, you play that at one. Like, it's got its uses, but, like, you know, it's kind of far in between. But it's still not right. Sorry.
Then, like, Proxy and Eagle Talker.
Right. All right, so basically, that there right there is the Pen Magician deck. It's definitely a pretty solid deck. You get to see it. If you want to see it in action, go ahead and watch the damn it, the locals video that I posted just before this, and you'll go ahead and get to see it in action. It's the second game. Thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Hope to see you for the next video. Peace.